Well, good morning, everybody, and welcome to worship. It's a gift to be here with all of you, and welcome, whether you're in your living rooms or wherever you are. It's a gift to join together with God's people by Spirit in worship today. This morning we have, I think, a really lovely gift that's been put together by a number of members of our congregation. It's called a Scripture and Song Service. And we've reached out to people all around our church and asked them to share with us a favorite scripture or a song that helps them as they go through life. And people really responded. And so we have a wonderful collection, not just of songs and scriptures that help people, but also some of the stories that people associate with those songs and scriptures. So today I'm really excited to welcome us into this time. Let me pray for us and we'll get started. Gracious God, you are the one who made us. You knit us together in our mother's womb, and you made this beautiful world. You gave us hearts that beat with a rhythm. You gave us minds that love beautiful music. And we think of all the ways in which music is created and draws our minds and our hearts to you. Though you are always speaking through the world around us, through song, and through the precious words of Scripture. So Lord, as we join together today, would we hear your words speaking, not just to our heads, but to our hearts as well, so that we might be lifted up and draw more closer to you, filled with grace, so that we can share that same grace with others. We pray all this in Jesus' name, and all God's people said, Amen. Well, friends, a new day has dawned. May Jesus Christ be praised. The dawning of a new day is the awakening of the world. Another day of life, a special gift from our Creator. So our first song is called When Morning Gilds the Sky. And it's a favorite of Jan Walker's, telling the story of creation and God's love for us.
Thanks, Josh. Another song rejoicing in the morning is Morning Has Broken, and this is special to Carol as she has memories of her sister, Georgia, who as a 14-year-old was practicing this song to play for the morning church service. Now Georgia's gone on to teach hundreds of pupils the piano, and Carol loves the tune and the words, which have a special meaning for her.
More has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them springing fresh from the world. Sweet the rain's new fall, sunlit from heaven, like the first dew fall on the first grass. Praise for the sweetness of the wet garden, sprung in completeness where his feet. Mine is the sunlight, mine is the morning, born of the one light, Eden saw play. Praise with elation, praise every morning, God's recreation of the new day. Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them springing fresh from the world.
Our next song is from Barry, and it's called Trust and Obey. It's based on the words of Proverbs 3, 5 to 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. And as we consider this Bible reading today, ask that you pray that it will have a great meaning to us all, so that we might be able to feel the presence of the risen Christ, who's always with us. You, Lord Jesus, are our friend. You're with us at all times. You're our companion, our hope. You are the way, the truth, the resurrection, and the life.
When we walk with the Lord in the light of his word, what a glory he sheds on our way. While we do his good will, he abides with us still, and with all who will trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Sorrow we share, but our toil he doth richly repay. Not a grief nor a loss, not a frown or a cross, but is blessed if we trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy us but to trust and obey. What we never can prove, the delights of His love, until all on the altar we joy He bestows are for them who will trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Then in fellowship sweet, we will sit at His feet, or we'll walk by His side in the way. What He says we will do, where He sends we will go. Never fear, only trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey.
As with Barry, my favourite verse is the one just quoted from Proverbs. Certainly, there have been many times in my life when I've failed to acknowledge Him, but He has always been faithful. In 2010, I felt God calling me to an outreach mission in the Philippines. This was despite being on strong painkilling medication prior to commencing an immunology drug trial. I certainly had to rely on prayer to get me through, as the medication failed. The first Sunday on my return, one of the hymns was "Great is Thy Faithfulness," summing up the love of God for me and for everyone with this assuring promise. Carol says she has many verses underlined and highlighted in her Bible as she tries to understand this man called Jesus and his message to us today. In Hebrews 11, verse 1 and 6, faith makes us sure of what we hope for and gives us proof of what we cannot see. But without faith, no one can please God. We must believe that God is real and that He rewards everyone who searches for Him. And I can assure you from my experience that that is true.
Faithful.
experience him is lead kindly light. And as an introduction, it was part of the initiation ceremony as that about 70 years ago, Marion became a Ray, which is a group of young girls in the Methodist Church. Each person entering this group was blindfolded, led by the hand towards the person in charge, who was my mother, the deputy chief Ray at the time. And as we walked forward, the whole group sang this hymn. These words seemed symbolic and very meaningful to me. And about 50 years later, my younger brother and I were able, while holding our father's hands, to sing these words, one of his favourite hymns, as he was struggling for breath. And so it is still significant for me today. Jesus spoke to them saying, I am the light of the world. He who follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. And that comes from John chapter 8, verse 12.
As we come near to our time of prayer, we'll walk as him, Dear Lord and Father of mankind, reminds us of our need for forgiveness and confession. favourite choruses is number 61 in Scripture in Song. It's called Whatever You Ask For in Prayer. And it goes something like this.
Whatever you ask for in prayer, having faith and really believing, you will receive, you will receive.
This song is based on Jesus' words to his disciples in Matthew chapter 21, verse 22. And they are words we can hold on to in our daily lives. Here are four different Bible translations of that passage. The first one from the Living Bible in Jesus' words. You can get anything, anything you ask for in prayer, if you believe. The second one from the Big Rescue, that's the children's version. Jesus said, if you have faith when you pray, you will be given whatever you ask for. From the third one, the Message, that's our modern version. Absolutely everything, ranging from small to large, as you make it part of your believing prayer, it gets included as you lay hold of God. And the fourth one from the Old Faithful King James Version. And all things, whatsoever ye shall ask in prayer, believing, ye shall receive. So let's come before God now with our prayers of thanksgiving and intercession. Let's pray. Loving Heavenly Father, here we are again in lockdown. Please help us to be patient and to give thanks for the many blessings we receive day by day. Thank you for the scriptures, and we hold on to your promise, Lord Jesus, in Matthew chapter 21, verse 22, that says, whatever we ask for in prayer, having faith and really believing, we will receive. What a wonderful promise. Thank you. Thank you too for your love and grace towards each one of us. Thank you for this beautiful part of the world, for our families and comfortable homes, and for our church family. We pray your blessing on each member of our congregations, both of them, as they use their special gifts to shine your light in this area, especially our new minister, Josh McPaul, and his family. Thank you for our Friday night community dinner congregation. We ask that those who come would feel your spirit here. In silent prayer now, Heavenly Father, we lift up to you other people that are on our hearts at this time. We thank you for our State Premier, Gladys Berejiklian, who is doing her best to make the right decisions for the people in this state, and that we are still able to go out for essential reasons. We ask that people would take it seriously and that we'll be able to return to normality soon, without any loss of life. Thank you that here in Wollongong, we've escaped a major outbreak so far, and we pray with shameless audacity that that will continue. Please continue to guide the decisions of our Prime Minister, Scott Morrison, all the state premiers and local councils. Father, our hearts are broken by the things that break your heart, and we particularly lift up to you the situation in Miami, with the loss of lives after the collapsed apartment building. We can't begin to understand the horror that of those affected by it. But we pray, Lord, for comfort for those who have lost loved ones and for those who have lost their homes. We pray for protection over those who are doing their utmost to find survivors. and we pray for the mayor of the city as she tries to find answers. Thank you, Father, for the power of prayer and for the privilege of being able to lift up these prayers to you in faith. Summer and winter and springtime and harvest, sun, moon and stars in their courses above, join with all nature in unspoken witness to your great faithfulness, Lord, mercy and love. Amen.
The deep, deep love of Jesus has special meaning for me. Years after I was fighting my way out of a submerging car one stormy night in the bottom of Wollongong Harbour, the realisation of these words actually struck me. Rolling as a mighty ocean in its fullness over me. Underneath me, all around me, is the current of thy love. God's love completely surrounds us in whatever situation we may find ourselves. In Isaiah 41, verse 10, we read, "Fear not, for I am with you, said the Lord." Lil's song is, "It is no secret what God can do." And Lil says, "This song is very special because it brings back memories of my mother. She was in hospital, struggling with the decision to go ahead with major complicated surgery when she heard this song being played. It reassured her and gave her the confidence to go ahead with the operation." In Luke chapter 1, verse 37, we read, "With God, nothing is impossible."
The chimes of time ring out the news another day is through. Someone slipped and fell. Was that someone you? You may have longed for added strength, your courage to renew. Do not be disheartened. I have news for you. It is no secret what God can do. What he's done for others, he'll do for you. With arms wide open, he'll pardon you. secret what God can do. There is no night, for in His light you'll never walk alone. You'll always feel at home wherever you may roam. There is no power can conquer you while God is on your side. Take Him at His promise, don't run away and hide. It is no secret what God can do, what He's done for others, He'll do for you. With arms wide open, He'll pardon you. It is no secret what God can do.
Pat's song is Blessed Assurance. And Pat says, years ago, I felt my faith was an inheritance from my grandmother and my mother. I regularly attended Sunday school from an early age. I was baptised and confirmed, but I battled with myself, accepting that faith was my decision. The catalyst came when I heard the words of the hymn, Blessed Assurance. At last, I could accept the fact that faith was my personal decision, and I could personally claim, Jesus is mine. My favourite Bible verse is Psalm 121. I will lift mine eyes to the hills. From whence cometh my help? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. 70 years ago, Sunday school exams were held, and the first psalm I recall learning for this exam was Psalm 121. Living here between the mountain and the sea, God's beauty surrounds us, and we are blessed with His grace.
Spirit. The hymn we've chosen to share with you today is Be Still My Soul. This is Amy Grant's 2015 recording of two of its verses, and it's been edited by Will. Maybe you'll recognise some of the images in the video. The hymn was originally written in German in 1752 by Catherine von Schlegel, and about 100 years later translated into English by Jane Borthwick, and then just a little later set to this tune, Finlandia, in 1899. We don't know how or where God will use us or what we do in the future. Will found Amy Grant's rendition on YouTube, and it was a blessing and comfort when preparing my dad's funeral. It's the promises of scripture woven into song. Later, I learned that this hymn had been particular comfort and encouragement for my dad as well. God is faithful, and we can trust him in all situations.
Be still, my soul. The Lord is on thy side. Bear patiently the cross of grief or pain. Leave to thy God to order and provide. In every change, he faithful will remain. Be still, my soul, thy best, thy heavenly friend. Through thorny leads to a joyful end. Be still, my soul, thy God doth undertake to guide the future as he has the past. Thy hope, thy confidence, let nothing shake. All now mysterious will be bright at last.
Our next hymn is from Alison. It's called And Can It Be? This was a song written by Charles Wesley on his celebration his own conversion. It speaks about God's amazing love and the sacrifice for us despite our own sinfulness and the undeserved grace bestowed upon us.
Thank you.
Graham has submitted a song, How Great Thou Art. Graham is a farmer and he's reminded every day of the beauty of our Creator's handiwork. The birth of a baby lamb still amazes him. How great is our God? This song was written by a pastor who was caught up in a storm returning from an afternoon service. There were loud claps of thunder, lightning flashed across the sky, strong winds blew across the wheat. When the skies cleared, a beautiful rainbow appeared, and he wrote these words. From Psalm 19, verse 1, the heavens declare the glory of God, and the earth shows his handiwork.
Amen. How great God is. Well, friends, this has just been a wonderful service, not just to hear the songs, but also to hear people's hearts and the way in which each of these songs and scriptures has woven into the stories of our lives. It's a difficult time in the life of our world, as Sandy prayed for us. And one of the members of our congregation, Rob Nance, has written this. He says, given the present crisis that the world is going through and the personal crises of several members of our congregation, it's appropriate also to spend some time with the book of Lamentations. Lament is something sometimes that we talk about that is an invitation to holy grief, to name the places where things are unresolved. So many songs are praising God and lifting up powerful, positive emotions. But we're also invited and given great permission by God and the man of sorrows himself, Jesus Christ, to grieve and to lament. And so I want to give a reading that Rob suggested from Lamentations chapter 3, verse 19. It says this, I remember my affliction, the bitterness and the gall. My soul is downcast within me. Yet I recall this to mind, and I have hope. Because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed, for his compassions never fail. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The song that Rob suggested is a wonderful chorus called The Steadfast Love of the Lord Never Ceases.
The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new.
Amen. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. Good songs come to us in times of need. I love hymns that use music to bring home the simple truths of the gospel. When we're anxious and overwhelmed, although it's important to remember scripture, it can be hard to bring it to mind in those times. And music is a gift from God. It has the power to direct our thoughts towards God, even when that hamster wheel of worry is going over and over and over again. My song that I've chosen for this morning is the refrain of My Hope is Built on Nothing Less. Those words have stayed with me during difficult times. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. We don't have any hope if we don't have hope in Jesus. In my old church, we used to do a reggae version of this song, which got everyone dancing. And I've heard many peaceful acoustic versions that are truly beautiful. But the power of the message, Christ is the solid rock, comes through with every arrangement.
Solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking.
Amen. Well, friends, now it's time to come to the close of our service. And traditionally, we give what's called the benediction, which literally just means a good word. And Lisa Floyd has suggested as we end the service to use the benediction song. The words and the tune of this song, she says, bring the service to a close and bring us together, knowing God is our beginning and our end. Amen.
Now unto Him who is able.